everyone. I'm back in my art room today. Today I'm going to do a chain pull. Maybe a string pull too. Maybe a balloon splash too. Anyways, I'm just going to review how to do a chain pull, how to do a string pull. So I'm just using a canvas board 9x12. And I'm going to put some white, I have some white house paint. And I'll put that down. So one of the tricks is not to have the layer of paint on this board too thick. If there's too much paint on here, then the chain or string just sinks into all the paint. You get a better effect if there's less paint, in my opinion anyway. So this is house paint, using my little silicone brush. Don't want it too thin either, so that the canvas is showing. You want to make it anyway. I think that looks pretty good. I'm going to take my torch and see if I can get the air bubbles out. So I would like to do a couple of colors. So what I'm going to do is lay some paint. I'm going to get one of my chains, see if it's long enough. I'll use this one first. Not sure if you can, yeah, you can see. Sometimes, usually you can dip it in here if you just want one color. Oh, I forgot, I was going to add some dimethicone to my paint. I don't often like a lot of cells in my string or chain pulls, but today I'm gonna go for it. This is a metallic purple. I don't know where my tube is for that one. It was here a minute ago. And this is a magenta, permanent magenta by Artist Loft. I also have a turquoise that I probably will use too. So instead of dipping it in the paint, I'm going to just layer the paint in my tray. I can just dip it. Purple and the magenta. Gonna make sure it's all covered. Okay. finger on it helps a little better. Just normal consistency. Runs off smooth off the stick. I shouldn't have any excess. Just gonna make sure. All right, let's try this. I'll do it here. Oops, sorry, I'm knocking the camera. This thing is so long. Just take your chain, lay it down. You can go in whatever pattern you want. I always seem to go to this pattern for some reason. I seem to like it. Now this is a little short, so I'm just gonna hold it for a minute. I'm not worried about the bottom right now. I might do something else down there. I guess that's long enough. So just make sure your chain is laid right into the paint. And I usually have a cup of water here, and I forgot my water. One very cell-like. Now that's a chain. Now let's see what it would look like if I did a string. I'm gonna see if this one might be a bit too long. I'll really go for the long one. I'm going to go for two different materials here. This is like just cotton string. Comes on a roll like this. Butcher string, cotton string, I don't know. I just got it at either the dollar store or Walmart. I forget where I got it. Some more over here, just dab it in. There, I think that's probably enough. I'll do it right beside it. And you'll see the difference. Not a big difference, but like less texture, less divisions of the petals. Make sure it's all covered and down. And you just pull straight. See, that part didn't have a lot of paint on it. This is going to be less. Some of them are less, depending on how much paint was on the string. There. little different. Not a big difference. Now I should wash my chain. Put some water in a little cup. Do another chain. This obviously needs more paint. Okay, so I'm gonna squirt some turquoise in here. That one, I'm not sure if I'm, no, I'm gonna leave it because I might go over the bottom again. We'll see. Making sure it's all in the paint. This one's all covered. This is just a ball chain. You can get this at your local hardware store. Comes on a roll. Sit for a minute. Oh, look how pretty that turquoise is. Now I want turquoise there too. You can go over them. You surely can. But you know what I'm doing right now? I'm favoring the chain right now. So what I think I'm gonna do, I'm gonna wipe this one off. Like I have a damp cloth here. Just wipe it off. It's gonna go back in the color. And I am gonna go over that one again. It's very, very easy to do. Let's make sure I got enough paint on here. Using my finger, but I'm trying to wipe it as I go. All right. See what we can do here. Just go around it. Whoops. How did the, oh, I went the wrong way. I went this way before. Whoops, not quite long enough. That's okay, I'll just pull it. If you see any little bare spots, just add some to the top. Okay, I'm pulling. See, that might be a little thinner there because I already pulled once, so it probably pulled some of the white paint off. There. That's okay. So pretty. Get my one out of the water that I rinsed. One more, this one in my water. Let's add some more paint. I think I just saw a little goober there. I don't know what that is. Colors are awesome together. You probably couldn't go over more than once, especially if the paint's not that thick there, because you're just pulling the white paint off. Okay. We're good here. Stop wiggling. Let this sit for a minute. All right. There we go. Now, clean this one off. This one in my water. I think I might just do a couple of little ones near the bottom, and then I'm going to try something different, try something else. I find my finger works best. This isn't going to be a small one, is it? I'll just do one right here. All right. I see a spot right here. All right. Here we go. All right, I had a little idea. I'm not sure how this is gonna go, but I'm just gonna try a balloon smash on the bottom. So you're getting two lessons. Chain pull, string pull, and add a little balloon smash. Since I already have paint here, I just have a little balloon today. I'm gonna give this a whirl. You can do it this way, dab it in the paint like that, and then go for it, or you can put the paint on the canvas. Cool. Put them anywhere you like. I need a little bit of magenta in here. gonna try something. It's a wet blue and I didn't want it too wet. Okay. Do some baby ones. Little baby ones. Well, I think I'm pretty much done. You can press it harder, you get a bigger balloon, bigger flower. Maybe some little ones in the background. Enough. I feel like I should do some lines or something. There, I think I'm done. I think I'm done. All right, I think that's it. There's lots of pretty cells in there. I'm gonna hold it up for you. I feel like I don't like that mark right there. I'm gonna get some white paint. Going to go in here. There. I'm done. Stop, 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 stop. Oops. All right. I was going to hold it up for you. I think I tried that and then I got stopped. Or I did already. Anyway, there's something different. Just a little lesson on chain pulls, string pulls, and balloon smashes. And if you want your balloon smashes not to be so perfect, if there's more paint on the background, you'll get more of a puffier flower, I guess you would call it, or a different shape. You can take and try and make like little lines to make little indents. You don't have to. Probably not enough white paint on here, and it's starting to dry anyway. All right, I'm gonna turn it off now. I'm done. Okay, thanks for coming by. Bye-bye. Hello, everyone. I'm just here to show you the dried results. This was on a canvas board. Dried really good. It wasn't thick paint on here, so it dried really good. No cracking, nothing. A little bit of warp, but not too bad. I can flatten that. Just wet the back with water. Turn it over, put a book on it, and you're good to go after it dries in an hour or two. Okay? Thanks for watching. Bye.